Hello students, myself Raj Kiran Gupta, lab assistant for Digital System Designs lab. In this video, we would discuss about simulate and synthesis of multiplexers. What is a multiplexer? A MUX is a digital switch that has multiple inputs that are sources and a single output called destination. The select lines determine which input is connected to the output. Okay, and types of MUX are based upon the selection lines. We have for one selection line it is 2-to-1 MUX, and two select lines it is 4-to-1 MUX, and three select lines it is 8-to-1 MUX, and four select lines it is 16-to-1 MUX. A generalized block diagram for MUX is given below. So here you can see, so number of select lines are n, then inputs are given as 2 power n, and the output is only 1. Okay, let us go to the first basic 2-to-1 MUX block diagram. Okay, and the truth table for 2-to-1 MUX is, it has one selection line and output is Y, and whenever selection line is 0, output is connected to I0, and whenever the selection line is 1, output is connected to I1. So this is a MUX. Okay, and this is logical diagram of a 2-to-1 MUX, and this is it. Now let us start simulating the program for our MUX, that is 2x1 MUX. So the previously folder, whatever the created folder, that is class, is utilized for this purpose, so I am not creating anything. So go to project navigator and double click it to invoke the Xilinx software. So please close the previously opened projects if any they are, using file and close project. Okay, from file menu, new project as usual. So in this, the same location is utilized, it is class, and here I am using 2x1 MUX, or if you want you can use MUX 2x1, and top level source is HDL. Next, it is asking override this project. Yes, and product category is general purpose, and all these things are unchanged. Already you know this. Next, and finish. Right click on this design, that is whatever the hierarchy or our project is there, right click on it, new source, new Verilog module, same as the entity name, that is MUX 2x1. Next, give the inputs, yes, I0, I1, these are the inputs, and Y is the output, change it to Y output. Next, and finish. So this is the code here. So after typing the code, please save the code, and then right click on this project, new source again, select the Verilog test fixture and type in MUX 2x1 underscore TB. Next, MUX 2x1 is already associated, so associate it. Next, and finish. So initial begin, you have seen this, S is equal to 0, I0 equal to 0, I1 equal to 0 and 100. So let us give the instances. So S is equal to 0, I0 is equal to 0. I am changing it to I0 is equal to 1. Wait for 100 nanoseconds. Now S gets value of 1 and I0, sorry, I1, now I1 will be 0, so I1 will be selected. So I am leaving it, I mean waiting for 100 nanoseconds. Now change this, I0 is equal to 0 and I1 is equal to 1 and wait for 100 nanoseconds and dollar finish. Semicolon. Save the code. After this, in the implementation, select this under this design menu, select this implementation and select MUX2X1. Synthesize XST in the process window, double click on Synthesize XST to synthesize the project. Once this process is done, we can verify the truth table and all those things. Let us see. So RTL schematic, view RTL schematic, to double click it, it will open this RTL schematic. So this is our circuit diagram and here is an NOT gate and two AND gates and one OR gate. So this is the only crude model, I mean basic diagrams we can see. And in this technology schematic, we can see it elaborately. So here it is given with LUT, LUT3, and here we have 3 input buffers and 1 output buffer, and 3 input buffers are S, IBUF, that is input buffer, I0 input buffer and I1 input buffer and Y output buffer. If you double click this LUT3, it will open up the window called LUT dialog. In this, in the schematic tab, you can see the inputs I0, I1 and S, which are connected, how they are connected, and the circuit diagram is similar to that which we have presented in the PPT, and the equation is this one. Truth table, you can see for 3 inputs, so 3 input variables we have seen here, and Karnaugh map is this one, you can see through this one. And apart from this, you have to suppose to go for check syntax as well. Check syntax will check for syntax. I mean, this has to be done prior to this RTL schematic and view technology schematic. So we can see it once again. So this one and this way. Okay, after viewing this RTL schematic and view technology schematic, we need to go for design summary or reports. Double click on it to view the design summary, and in this synthesis report is there now, please click it, it will open up this window. This is your design summary, and in this synthesis report you can see, you scroll down to last of the page, you can see how many LUTs and I buffers have been utilized here. So here you can see how many bells have been utilized, LUTs, that is 1, and IO buffers are 4, I buffer is 3 and output buffer is 1 utilization, slice logic utilization, and all these things will be seen, and the timing report cannot be seen here. So it took 5.385 nanoseconds and all these things need to be seen. And this cross-clock domain reports, you need to note down this total real-time XST simulation. XST compilation is 9 seconds and total CPU time to XST compilation is 9.01 seconds. This you need to note down in your observation notebook. And total memory usage is these many bytes. Okay. After this, we will be going for simulation purpose. So under this design tab, you go for click on this simulation radio button and select this MUX2X_TB, and select under this process menu, you please select this simulate behavioral model and double click it to simulate the model. We will see the waveforms in no time. So this is the waveform, you can see and this is a button zoom to full view. You can see the waveform here. So firstly, whenever in the first transition, whenever the AC is zero, our Y was attaining the value of I naught. Okay, in the first transition, S was zero, so Y was attaining I naught as the input. How can we say that I1 is also zero? So which among this is seen? So in the second transition, then this is the button for next transition. So in the next transition, I have made this I naught to 1 and I1 as 0. So that we can differentiate that Y is getting the value of I naught. And since our S is 0, S is kept 0 wantedly, so I naught is selected for our Y. And coming to the next transition, here S is changed to 1, so Y will get the value of I1. So here I1 is 0, so our Y has got attained value of 0, that is I1 is reflected on Y. In the next transition of I1, we have wantedly changed the value of I0 to 0 and I1 to 1, so the transition is changed to input, that is I1. So output is Y is equal to I1. So this concludes the experiment for our 2 cross 1 in that is structural model. In the similar fashion, please do the experiments for 4 door to 1, 8 to 1 and 16 to 1 in all the 3 modeling methods. Thank you.